And you know what? I said, let's use this money to get the Pioneer DDJ 1000.
On the way to Canal Sound and Light, spending my stimulus check on, of course, DJ gear. But we had to take a drive into New York City. I live pretty close to it, and it's crazy. It's crazy. One of the reasons why I wanted to take this drive was because I wanted to see it for myself. I know you guys have seen the news, and everybody's talking about how crazy dead it is, and it really is. It's eerily calm and dead. There are still cars out on the road, but it's eerily calm. This is actually my first time in 38 days that I've left my house. I've been like in full quarantine, but I just wanted to see it just for the historic purposes, more or less. I wanted to see what New York City was like. I wanted to say I was there. I saw what it looked like. Yeah, there is nobody crossing. I just realized that. Look at all the graffiti. Yeah, you can see all of it now. So I was actually kind of nervous of coming out here because first I didn't even know if like the state borders were closed. I don't know why I thought that, but no, it was pretty normal to get through here. You know, I still had to pay my tolls, still went through the same process. The drive wasn't, I don't want to say it wasn't as long. It was the same. It just, I know how to time New York City right so that I don't hit traffic. But now as I'm going into the heart of it, I am starting to see more cars, but more where you enter from New Jersey into New York City, where it's usually super busy, is super dead. I'm here with Christian. Say what's up, Christian.
What's up?
So usually there on the sidewalks, you usually have a bunch of like, a bunch of hustlers out there on the road selling like fake Louis, fake Yeezys, fake Gucci, all those brands. They're usually all lined up right across here, and there is nothing there. Oh man, where are people gonna get their fake Gucci and Louis now?
I wonder what the simplest thing is. Oh,
mask on. Mask on. Here we are. New York City, Canal Sound and Light.
Contactless delivery.
Contactless delivery, yes. How you doing, man?
Not bad.
How different is this than what it usually is?
It is day and night.
Day and night, right?
Yeah, yeah. Normally, right now, it's Friday afternoon, cars lined up, like busy, rentals, sales.
Oh my God. When do you think it's gonna get back to normal here?
I don't know if they'll ever get back to normal.
Never?
Well
you'll eventually reopen, all right?
Yeah.
So Jeff is the one who's making it happen, everybody. I gotta send a huge thanks to Canal Sound and Light. Contactless delivery, look at this. 6 feet apart. Social distancing. Explain what's going on. So this is the DDJ 1000 SRT, and yes, this officially means that I am officially retiring my CDJs. My Nexus 2000 system, DJM 900, is now officially retired. And a lot of you guys may be wondering why. When I got it, that system was meant to be my stay-at-home system, and it actually was. For many years, that system never left my house because I wasn't a mobile DJ. So that system was really for me to mess around with at home. However, things have dramatically changed. 3 years ago, I made the move from being a club DJ to a mobile DJ, and I realized a couple of things. CDJs and turntables are no longer practical, especially if you're a mobile guy. They're big, they're heavy, they're bulky, they're just not fun to lug around. I eventually said to myself, you know what? I'm gonna get a controller. And I was on the fence because, to be honest, I was never a big fan of controllers. And then Pioneer put out their DDJ 1000. It was originally only made for their proprietary record box system. You guys saw that. I saw it at NAMM.
This is the DDJ 1000 record box controller. Look at this thing.
When I went to NAMM that year, I mentioned to you guys, I might be switching over to record box because that controller is so awesome.
Man, that is some next level stuff. I have not been excited about a piece of software, a piece of technology like that for a long, long time. That is a game changer. That might make me want to switch over from Serato to Rekordbox. And at $1,200, that's not a bad deal, so.
But I never pulled the trigger on it because switching softwares is something difficult to do, especially when you've been DJing for as long as I have. I've been using Serato for over 10 years now, so it would be a very difficult move to switch to another platform. And then last summer, Pioneer officially came out with the Serato version of that same controller that I fell in love with.
The video you and I shot, the first thing you asked me, does it work with Serato?
Yes.
No. So this is the DDJ 1000, the one you and I talked about, with the big change being using Serato.
I now have more time on my hands than I know what to do with, and I've been bored as hell at my house being in quarantine. And you know what? I said, let's use this money to get the Pioneer DDJ 1000 SRT. Controllers are just the way to go nowadays. So let's get into the unboxing. You guys already know that I love it. I'm just gonna show you guys what it's all about. This is the packaging right here. You guys can live vicariously through me. Boom. Oh, I thought this was an opening. Oh, this thing is light. It's actually a lot smaller than I thought. I did get the flight case for this thing. However, I'm going to make a dedicated video on the flight case and me actually building out the flight case, installing the power strip, putting in my chargers, all that stuff. That's coming later on this week. I love new toys. Woo! Here it is. Here it is. So this is it right here in all its glory. My biggest thing with this, as you guys can see, is the layout is exactly the same as my CDJ 2000 and my 900 mixer. It looks exactly the same. However, I now have the benefits of having my pads here. The jog wheels feel just like they do on my CDJ. They feel awesome. As far as effects go, I have to check it out to see if it's as good as the other mixer. The only one I really care about is the reverb. Reverb on this better be good because that's my biggest one that I use. One of my biggest pet peeves with Pioneer controllers, especially in the older models, was the fact that to use your mic, it did take up a channel on your mixer, and I hated that. I like a separate dedicated mic channel, and this one, it does have it here. As you guys can see, there's an XLR input and quarter inch input on the back. I also got the case with the 1U on the bottom, so I'm going to be installing my microphones right underneath. I do wish that these faders were black. Maybe I can order some black ones. These are the cables that it comes with. I don't like the fact that it is not an IEC. It does need a power brick. Not a fan of that. That's kind of amateurish. I would love to see an IEC, especially on a piece like this that's geared more towards pros. I would definitely say that this is a pro piece, but this connection sure ain't pro. Also, it's 2020. We are done with the USB-A. That's USB-B. But we are done with USB-A. Can we please just ship out with USB-C? Or ship with both, even if it costs you money. But it's so annoying that I have to go out and purchase a new USB-B to USB-C. Because most of us rock with newer computers. This is not even a new computer. This is 2016. It's been 4 years. Please start shipping with USB-C. Aside from that, this is a dope little controller, huh? But what do you guys say? This or these right here? These are my PLXs. I also bought them from Canal Sound and Light. I was actually messing around with it before this, but I needed to clean up so I can put the mixer there. But now I get to play around with this bad boy right here. This should be exciting. This setup right here is as close as you're gonna get to a club standard setup. It's just a great bang for your buck. Once you take into account taxes, a case for it, you're looking at about 1500, maybe 1600 bucks, depending on where you are. It's a pretty damn good deal versus that 5,000 or 6,000 that you'd be spending on a full club standard setup. I'll keep using this thing until I get bored of it. This is it, the DDJ 1000 SRT in all its glory. Thank you guys for joining me. This is how I spent my $1,200 stimulus check. How did you guys spend it? Let me know down in those comments below. Thank you for joining me on this short little vlog. I do want to send a huge shout out to my friends over at Canal Sound and Light for making this possible during the quarantine. Be on the lookout for the complete review of this unit once I wrap my head around it and start taking it out to some gigs to figure out what I don't like, what I do like, what I miss, what I don't miss. All that stuff is coming up soon. So be sure to like this video if you liked it. Subscribe if you're new around here and turn on that bell so that you can be notified next time we do another unboxing video of another awesome DJ controller. Once more, shout out to Canal Sound and Light for making this video possible, and I'll see y'all next time. Peace!